be discussing Judiciary Act of 1789. How it was established. The act was officially titled an act to establish the judiciary courts of the United States. Principally authored by Senator Oliver Ellsworth and also William Patterson. It was signed by the first president of the United States, George Washington, into law on September 24, 1789. According to Article 3 of the Constitution, it established the Supreme Court. It was left to Congress, which gave them authority to create lower federal courts as needed. For example, if there was a case that was lower and the lower courts could handle it, the lower courts would handle it, and it would not be sent to the Supreme Court, which is the higher courts. The Act established the structure and jurisdiction of the federal court system. It also created the position of Attorney General. The basic outline of the federal court system established by the first Congress remains largely complete today, as we have in the White House. About the Act. Of the ten amendments that eventually became the Bill of Rights, five dealt primarily with judicial proceedings. It was placed to make the courts precise and to sustain continuity. The Act divided the country into districts, with one court and one judge in each. It came along with attorneys responsible for civil and criminal actions in their districts. The Act also created the Office of Attorney Generals of the United States. The Attorney General, a member of the Cabinet, is appointed by the President and is head of the Department of Justice. There are nine justices in total. This is the Rule of Four. The Rule of Four is placed in the Supreme Court. The Rule of Four is the Supreme Court of the United States that practices permits four of nine justices to grant a writ and seeking judicial review. This is done specifically to prevent a majority of the court from controlling the court's docket. The Rule of Four is not required by the Constitution, but any law, even the Supreme Court, owns published rules. The Rule of Four has been explained by various justices and judicial opinions throughout the years. We will talk more about the judicial review, the structure of Judiciary Act. The Act established that the Supreme Court would be composed of one chief, justice, and five associates. Justices that an all decision of the Supreme Court would be final. The Act also vested in the Supreme Court the power of settle disputes between states and provided for mandatory Supreme review of the final judgments of the highest courts of any state in cases. There are two types of decision: majority opinions and minority opinions. Majority opinions is considered concurring opinions. Minority opinions is considered dissenting opinions. In Judiciary Act of 1789, Congress created constitutional courts. Congress has made legislative courts for certain purposes. For example, the Court of Military Appeals, the Court of Claims, the Court of International Trade, and the Tax Court. Judges who have fixed terms of office are represented in the legislative court. They cannot practice the power of judicial review without applying a body of law within their area of jurisdiction. The difference among courts. Original jurisdiction. Jurisdiction are those in which a case is head first, normally in a trial. And this jurisdiction are the courts that determine authentic information about a case. It can be criminal charge or civil suit. About 90% of court cases begin and end in the court of jurisdiction. Appellate jurisdiction hears cases brought to them on appeal from a lower court. Appellate courts do not review the factual record, only the legal issues involved. Marbury versus Madison. Judicial review was established by John Marshall and his connections in the case. This court had discovered that judicial act under the case of Marbury that it contradicted the plain words of the Constitution about the court's original jurisdiction. The chief accepted the power of judicial review. Judicial review is the power of the courts to determine whether acts of Congress and implications the executive in violations of the Constitution. Federal Supreme System. Federal Court System.